Hello everyone, welcome back. Welcome to Insect Pests of Crops lecture series. In this lecture, under the lecture 6B, we'll be discussing sucking pests and other minor pests of pulses. In fact, in the previous lecture, we were discussing the pod borer pests of pulses. Okay, if you look at the sucking pest complex, which mainly contributed by the pod bugs. Okay, so these pod bugs either belongs to family Coriidae or Alaridae. Of course, there are a number of species, which I'll be concentrating on few of the major corids and halidids, which includes Anoplechnimus faziana, Clavigrella gibbosa, Clavigrella arens, Cletus bipunctatus. Okay, all these belong to family Coriidae, whereas halidids includes Riptotus pedestris and Riptotus linearis. So we'll take one by one their identification and the damage they cause. So these are the habitus photos of Anoplechnimus faziana, Clavigrella gibbosa, Clavigrella arens, Cletus bipunctatus, Riptotus pedestris, and Riptotus linearis. We'll take one by one. Anoplechnimus faziana belongs to family Coriidae. So of course it is attacks number of other host plants, including major legumes. Sometimes it is also called tip withering bug, especially in case of grapes. Where it actually the sucking the sap leads to withering of the apical shoots, hence it's called tip withering bug, and is mainly distributed in India and Southeast Asian countries. And now you can identify with the help of this coloration, the body coloration. They are much larger, measures 2 to 2.5 centimeter, blackish brown in color, and their dorsal side of their abdomen is brick red and their ventral side is blackish brown. So this part, the wings are in fact covered. Otherwise, if you remove the wings, you'll find that brick red colored the dorsal side. Head is comparatively smaller. If you compare it with Alaridae, head is comparatively smaller. And they have got 4-segmented long antenna. Now the terminal segment is actually brick red in color, this part. So male and female have got sexual dimorphism. The male is comparatively slender. Okay. Whereas they have got this flattened tibia. Okay, so on they are strong. Comparatively, if you see the female, the tibia is comparatively stronger. Whereas in case of female, the abdomen is, you can see this triangular, and without any flattening of the side tibia. Okay, so thereby you can distinguish males and females of Anoplechnimus faziana. The other pests includes the belongs to genus Clavigrella, Clavigrella gibbosa, and Clavigrella arens. So they can be differentiated with the coloration again. Pale brown to greenish brown bug with fuscous brown patches. Okay, so and they measure about 2 centimeter in length with spines on either side of the middle of the prothorax. You can see here. Okay, so it arises from the middle of the prothorax, these spines. Whereas in case of Clavigrella arens, they are comparatively smaller to Clavigrella gibbosa. Overall brown to dark brown in color. So only clavus and membranes are lighter. Okay, this part. And humeral angles are sharply produced outward with a small black spines. Okay, black spines you can see here. Okay, so thereby you can distinguish Clavigrella gibbosa and the Clavigrella arens. And other pest is Cletus bipunctatus, again Coriidae. And again, it's a small bug, measures up to 1 to 1.03 centimeter. Head is dark yellow with brown punctures. Okay, humeral angles with a small size spine, again here you can see here. Okay, so of course, so if you really look into differentiating character, many times you need to dissect out the male genitalia and look for those characters in order to correctly identify the species which is occurring on any of those pulses. And if you come to two allied species which we were discussing, Riptotus linearis and Riptotus pedestris. So Riptotus linearis has got from head to metapleura, you can see up to last thoracic segment, there is a parallel sided fascia, this structure line with a fuscous border, so comparatively darker border you can see here. Okay, so this line, so probably that's why it's called Riptotus linearis. There is a linear line from head to metathoracic region, including a ridge like scent gland peritrine. Okay, so most of these bugs actually release nauseous smell when they are handled, especially targeted against predators. Whereas Riptotus pedestris can be identified with the help of shining yellow spots on the lateral side. So in the previously, we'll find a line, whereas you'll find these yellow spots, which is the diagnostic feature of Riptotus pedestris. So most of these pod bugs in general, so they suck the sap from from the parts. Okay, they prefer to attack the parts, hence they are called part bugs, in fact, but they do also suck the sap from stem, leaves, and flower buds. So majorly, now especially in the reproductive stage, they attack the parts. So whenever the parts are attacked, they show pale yellow patches. Okay, when the attack is heavy, the parts actually shrivel up. You can see here. The grains, the attacked parts remain shriveled and extremely small, whereas you can see the healthy grains. So that's why, so most of these part bugs, in fact, causes up to 30 to 35% loss. So any of these species which we are discussing. So how do you manage these part bugs impulses? So many times you need to collect and destroy the eggs. You need to look for those egg masses, generally which are laid in mass of 10 to 15. So otherwise you'll get the nymphs and adults regularly in the field. So they may be hand collected or swept with the help of insect net, and they should be destroyed. Spraying any of the systemic insecticide, especially it may be acephate, dimethoate, or thiomethoxam, or spinosad. Okay, so depending on the suggested concentration dosage, they needs to be sprayed. Okay, so another sucking pest which infests the pulses is Coptozoma crinoidea. Field bean, red gram, many other pulses may be attacked. So usually these flat bugs, in fact, congregate on the plant parts and sucks the juice. So they are greenish colored with a characteristic buggy odor. So when they are handled, in fact, they release nauseous smell, very bad smell. So they usually cluster and sucks the sap. And Nejara viridula, it's called southern green stink bug, pentatomid, major pest on legumes, so widely distributed, which is native of Ethiopia, and now majorly in the tropical and subtropical region of the world, including Europe, Asia, Africa, and other Americas. So in most of these countries, it is considered as a serious pest and attacks a wide range of hosts, not only these pulses. So this is the Nejara viridula, which lays the eggs in masses, and the early instar, first instar, you can see comparatively brick red, and later it turns to black, second instar, third instar, fourth instar, and later it actually starts turning to green. Okay, so these are the adults. So nymphs are light yellowish in color, and red eyes and transparent legs and antenna, you can see here. Okay, so very common pest. So it's a highly polyphagous, attacks leguminaceous, but also cruciferae, poaceae, malvaceae, solanaceous also attacked. So wherever it inserts the proboscis and sucks the sap, and discoloration occurs and grains get shriveled. So these are the eggs. Okay, so nymphs and adults sucks the sap, leading to black or brown lesions, leading to abnormal shape of those grains, premature drop, okay, honeydew, so normally found, and sooty mold actually grows. So bean aphid, Apis craxivora, another serious pest which is widely distributed, you can see, throughout the world. So this insect is distributed throughout the world, mainly legumes are attacked, sometimes cruciferous crops, so damaged. So distributed worldwide. So you can see the congregation of these black aphid, Apis craxivora. Okay, so on leaves, inflorescence, stalk, young parts. Okay, so wherever they are, they will be in colonies. They suck the sap, release large quantity of honeydew. That leads to development of sooty mold that attracts, in fact, that honeydew, in fact, attracts black ant. So that sooty mold, wherever actually it grows, so that reduces the photosynthetic activity. So as a result of that, so the plant growth, the plant growth actually gets stunted, and chlorosis may also happen, especially if the seedlings are attacked. Okay, so there will be total loss of the plants. Or even in the later stage, if the damage occurs, so usually the flower bearing capacity of the plant get affected. So thereby yield reduction occurs. So another sucking pest which causes both direct and indirect damage is Bemisia tabaci. Okay, which directly sucks the sap. Okay, like aphid, they do secrete large quantity of honeydew, sooty mold growth. So similar type of damage, the direct damage they cause. But these white flies, Bemisia tabaci, also transmits viral disease, mainly Gemini virus, like bean yellow vine mosaic virus, which is generally called BYVMV, with another group of virus, which is more or less has got genetic relationship with BYVMV, is mung bean yellow mosaic virus, MYVMV, which causes different types of symptoms. You can see in field also, you'll notice large number of plants infected with this mung bean yellow mosaic virus. Okay, very common virus, which is exclusively transmitted by white flies, Bemisia tabaci. And other sucking pests includes mealybugs, which may be Fericia virgata, are Coccidohystrix insulata, especially in case of red gram. So these two species of mealybugs occurs. So how do you manage these sucking pests, which may be aphids, whiteflies or mealybugs, and moonbeam yellow mosaic virus, which is transmitted by whiteflies. So wherever you find the infected plants in the field, so those needs to be collected and burnt. Otherwise, which acts as a source of inoculum and secondary spread occurs in the field. So in order to avoid the inoculum moving from an infested tree field or outside field to main field or river field, the important practice is actually growing maize as a border crop. Okay, so that reduces the movement of these vectors and reduces the incidence, along with one spray of NSK 5% or fish oil rosin soap at the rate of 5 ml per liter of water, found effective in reducing white flies, aphids, as well as virus incidence. So most of these oils are also effective against mealybugs, which covers as a layer and reduces the respiration. Another important systemic insecticide which is widely used against most of the sucking pests includes thiomethoxam at the rate of 0.5 gram per liter of water, or imidacloprid at the rate of 0.3 ml per liter of water are found to be very effective against these sucking pests. So another mite pest which is very serious, especially in red gram, is Escherichia kajani. So it is a iriophyte mite. Iriophyte mite, we know that it has got two pairs of legs, whereas unlike other tetranychid mites, other mites will have four pairs of legs. Okay, Escherichia kajani. So very specifically damage red gram. So the direct damage caused by this Escherichia kajani is very less, in fact, but indirectly, it transmits one of the deadliest virus called Pigeon pea sterility mosaic virus, PPSMV. So wherever this virus actually occurs, the loss of up to 100% has been reported. So that means if the plant of a vegetative stage is carrying the virus, so there will not be any flower production at all. So if there is no flower production, automatically yield get affected. So there will not be any yield at all. So this sterility mosaic disease is characterized by stunted and bushy plants, leaves of reduced size, with chlorotic rings or mosaic symptoms, and partial or complete cessation of flower production. Partial cessation may occur if the virus infection occurs in the later stage of the crop. If it occurs in the early stage of the crop, there will be total cessation of flower production. So that's why it's called sterility. Sterile plant, sterile mosaic virus. So how do you manage this virus? In fact, so rogging out or removal of infected plants is must. You need to identify such symptomatic plants and need to be removed. So growing some of the resistant varieties like ICPL 151 and Hyderabad 3C. Spray acaricides, in order to remove the populations of these mites. Dicofal, 2 ml per liter of water. Wettable sulfur, 3 gram per liter of water. Or profenofos, 2 ml per liter of water. Or NSKE 5%, which has got broad spectrum of activity. So these are the sucking pests. If you list these, some of the minor pests, which may be Homeoids indicata, belongs to family Crambidae, which attacks wide range of pulses. So which scrapes and fold the leaves and remain within those foldings and feed on the green matter. So this is adult Homeoids indicata. And blister beetle, Hyclea species, which was earlier called Mylabris pustulata, so attacks especially red gram, which feeds on the flowers. So how to manage these? Blister beetle is that hand collection is best. So it's very difficult in case of red gram to go for canopy spray and remove the infestation of these blister beetles. So the best way is to hand collect them and destroy them. Another polyphagous pest, which occurs in minor proportion on various pulses. Sometimes, of course, many of these polyphagous pests may occur in sporadically in a very serious form. Viary caterpillar, Spilatia obliqua. So when they hatch from the eggs, they will be congregated. So they remove the green matter, acts as skeletonizers. Later they move individually, they scatter and feed on the entire plant. So this is the adult of Spilatia obliqua. And spingid, so a caterpillar which grows to very large size and attacks any of these pulses. Single caterpillar may be enough to remove the foliage of any plant. But occurs in minor proportion. Acherontia sticks, spingid. Then a prominent moth, which is called Neostaropus alternus, not odontidae, which specifically when they are disturbed. Now it raises his abdomen, the last abdomen segment, like a snake would. Okay, you can see here. So that actually shows off their defensive strategy against the predators. Okay. So Neostarapus alternus belongs to family Notodontidae. Very characteristic larva, in fact. And Sagra femorata is a presumulid beetle, okay, with a widened hind femur. And these, in fact, adults place the eggs in the veins, especially which is very common in indeterminate type of a field bean. Okay, it's the long duration field bean, which are usually allowed to grow on the top of the houses. And usually, so the grubs of these insects, the Sagra femorata, feeds on the vines, and as a result, usually you'll find the gall formation wherever these grubs are there. So that typically you'll find in indeterminate type of field bean. So another minor pest which occurs on pulses. So I'll end this lecture with few questions. What is the long form of CABMV, which is actually a virus name, and its vector? Coptozoma cribraria belongs to which family? I didn't tell the answer when I was going through the slides. How do you differentiate Poridae from Malaridae? Okay, species composition and management of pod bugs in pulses. Okay, we listed many of those Porids and Alaidids. Thank you very much. If there are any questions, you can post below, or you can email me as well. So thank you very much.